What's up, geeks, and welcome to the channel. I received a lot of requests concerning Maven and Gradle, and while preparing for a Maven vs. Gradle video, I realized that before actually working on such an upload, it made a lot of sense to start this series by explaining what build tools are in general, and then dive into Java build tools specifically. So, what are build tools? What do we mean by build automation? And how do these tools contribute to this automation? Let's start with the build itself. You see, the build is a process of preparing source code for production so that users can happily interact with it. It may include compilation, file compression, updating database schema, creating an installer or executable file, etc. Now, automating that build, or build automation, is an approach to handling builds within a CI/CD pipeline that has several steps. A developer commits source code to a repository, a CI server detects the change, runs the build process outside of the developer's IDE, i.e. on a dedicated cloud or in-house machine, then checks its unit's tests and either returns for fixes or sends it further down the pipeline. Automation helps standardize builds, make them faster, and avoid awkward mistakes typical for humans doing things manually. But how does that work? Well, usually the build automation process is part of a larger CI/CD pipeline in DevOps. The main steps I want to focus on today are: 1. A developer commits code to a repository. The commit term comes from the realm of version control systems, which are services that help manage updates to the software, such as Git. A code commit operation means that an engineer sends a new code to a repository residing inside one of those VCs. 2. The CI server detects changes inside the repository. A CI server is a system that orchestrates a CI pipeline, allowing teams to commit code multiple times per day and build automatically outside of their workstations on different target servers. So a CI server regularly polls a repository to check for new commits and save changes in a separate database. CI server software allows engineers to tweak build configuration, add build agents that execute build jobs on dedicated machines, and integrate with build tools. What do these terms mean? Let's keep exploring the process. 3. Build configuration recognizes changes and triggers a build agent. A build configuration is a set of rules determining how the build is supposed to happen. For instance, it sets the timing when the build begins. Example, once a new code commit arrives, or at 5 p.m. every day, or after some external process is finished like a security scan. Here you can also define exactly which operations and which tools you need to complete the build, adjust the steps, or configure your VCS settings. Build configuration sees changes in a CI server database and, based on settings, initiates different build agents. 4. Build agent activates build tools. A build agent is a program deployed on a build server, normally outside of the CI server, that takes orders from the CI server and starts a build. It's important that a single commit can trigger several parallel agents on different target machines, say for different operating systems. The agent doesn't compile code, compress files, generate installers, or do any kind of low-key dirty work. It just listens to what a server with its configuration has to say and orders build tools to do their job in the way a developer configured. There may be a sequence of operations on the code that amounts to a build. The agent triggers those operations in a set order. 5. Build tools compile, compress, run tests, etc. Finally, build tools do their low-level work. A build tool is a script, framework, or any kind of software created specifically for a given programming language to compile code, run tests on it, or do other operations needed for a build. The CI server should support integrations with such tools. For example, Maven and Gradle are popular for Java compilation and unit testing. MS Build is popular with C# and C++. And to run tasks on JavaScript code, Grunt can be used, etc. At this step, unit tests are the most likely to be used and run, as they are the lowest level quality assurance checks that verify that the component works as intended. Some build tools already have unit testing support. 6. Build artifacts are sent back to the server. If the code passes all build stages, including testing, it will normally be sent to the CI server, at which point it can go to production, further testing, or other storage, depending on how your CI/CD pipeline works. Build code comes in build artifacts, files ready to be developed and executed, for example, .exe for Windows. Another interesting thing to take note of is that there are two types of builds, full and incremental. In incremental builds, normally, the process takes less than 10 minutes as you don't build the entire code base, but rather those parts of source code that have experienced changes. Build tools take care of finding the changed files. In full or clean builds, all code files are taken and rebuilt from scratch. These builds are less common because they take a lot more time. In fact, incremental builds are widely considered as the default way to build the code base. So, to sum everything up, build automation is the process of automating the tasks necessary to create, execute, and test programs. After we create the source code for a program, build automation comes in to process and prepare the source code for deployment to production. Build automation is a best practice and prerequisite for any continuous integration process in DevOps. Most modern development teams have an established build automation process. This process helps save valuable time and resources for developers and development teams who once carried out these tasks manually. With that said, build tools are applications used for build automation. The choice of build tool would depend on the languages and frameworks we're using. Build tools facilitate a wide variety of build automation tasks, such as compiling source code into machine code, dependency management, identifying and patching necessary third-party integration, automated tests, executing tests and reporting failure, and packaging the application for deployment, prepares source code for deployment to servers. Stay tuned for the upcoming videos of this series in which we will dive deeper into Java build tools and explore popular CI servers such as Jenkins. So that's it for this video. I hope it was helpful. Thank you guys for watching. Take care, and I will see you in the next one.